Magic Weekend isn't just about Super League. It's a festival of rugby league, as Russ Finnis has been finding out.
We're in the shadow of Anfield in Stanley Park, where 160 people have come together from 10 different teams to celebrate the launch of Learning Disability Super League.
The opportunity that you can see behind me here is that 160 people are getting to play rugby who never used to have that kind of opportunity before. The difference this makes for people is huge. So many people with disabilities end up being quite isolated, don't get the same opportunities to be part of their community. These guys are, as you can see, thoroughly enjoying themselves. They're getting to engage in an activity that they've loved for years, they've been fans of rugby for years, and really for us the main thing here is that we get to take people who have disabilities into a space that means that they're thoroughly engaged with what they love, but more importantly than that, they're doing activities that change their lives.
So Oliver, tell me what it's like being a Warrington Wolves Super League player.
Warrington Wolves player, it means a lot to me. It's been a part of my blood, and it's really good to be here and to play as well. This is good.
Are you a winning team?
Yeah. We're getting trained up on a Friday night, six or seven, and we just keep on trying and do what we do best, really.
Playing like an actual work for a church, it just feels like a honour, really.
It really does change lives. It takes them out of isolation, it gives them confidence, that means that they're keen to try other things as well. So these guys are just stepping forward into opportunities day after day because of the fact they're getting to play rugby. I mean, it doesn't sound a lot to many people, but for these guys, that's absolutely massive.
Well, they've also been showcasing the Physical Disability Rugby League, which of course means comedian Adam Hills has had a run out at Anfield. You are living the dream here, aren't you, fella?
I mean, less than a year and a half ago, we had our first ever physically disabled game of rugby league in the UK. It was at Victoria Park between Leeds and the Warrington Wolves. I played for the Wolves. And now we're at Anfield in front of however many thousand people. And what I loved about today in particular, I just want as many people as possible to see physically disabled rugby league because it's brilliant. And to hear people get excited when tries were scored, to groan when big tackles were made, I love that because you know everyone's going, I thought they were disabled, when some guy with one leg melts a guy with one arm. It's proper rugby league.
And it is growing so quickly, and if you're looking towards the World Cup as well, who are you going to play for?
I mean, it would have to be Australia. If selected, it would have to be Australia. But the worst part about doing that is, I played one game in Australia. We took our team out to Australia last year and we played against the Rabbitohs PDRL team. And I was allowed to play half a game for the Rabbitohs because they're my boyhood club. I've never been hit harder in a tackle than when I played against my teammates. So if I played for Australia against the blokes I know, I would really cop some hits, I reckon.
On a serious note, it is so good to see it growing.
Especially at the moment. I mean, you've got the LDRL, the Learning Disability Rugby League. You've got Wheelchair Rugby League, which is different to wheelchair rugby. So Wheelchair Rugby League is a bit more like able-bodied rugby league. You've got the Women's Rugby League coming along as well. It really, what I've realised is, particularly in England, it's a community sport. It's a family sport. And it's a progressive sport. And it's now one of the most accessible sports in Britain.
And you are well and truly a Wolf, aren't you? When I spoke to you a few years ago, you didn't know who you were when it came to this
country. I know, and I remember you saying I should be a Castleford fan. And it was only when we played against Cass, the first time we played against Cass, that I thought, oh my God, I nearly supported them. Now they're the enemy. No, once a while, always a while.
Lovely to speak to you and keep up the good work.
Thank you. You too.